Hello everyone. In this video, I am going to explain you SSL web security. The problem statement that you have to implement in a lab is configure and demonstrate the use of SSL web security. So this is the problem statement and we are implementing the digital certificate, self-signed digital certificate. What is SSL? SSL stands for the Secure Socket Layer. It is a transport layer security service. It is originally developed by Netscape. Version 3 is designed with public input. Subsequently became internet standard known as TLS, Transport Layer Security. It uses TCP to provide a reliable end-to-end service. OpenSSL is a robust, commercial-grade and full-featured toolkit for the transport layer security and secure socket layer protocol. It is also a general-purpose cryptography library. OpenSSL is licensed under an Apache-style license. So, OpenSSL is a toolkit which is used for TLS, that is transport layer security. It contains a set of cryptography APIs or the libraries. Why do you need OpenSSL? To generate the private keys, to create CSR, that is certificate signing request, to install your SSL certificate, and to identify the certificate information. What is meant by SSL certificate? SSL certificates are used for the distribution of the public key and it is used for the authentication purpose. SSL certificate is a security protocol which secures data between the two computers by using encryption. An SSL certificate is a data file that digitally ties a cryptographic key to a server or a domain and an organization's name and location. So, SSL certificate mainly used for the authentication purpose. So, it contains the public key, the organization name and the location. SSL certificate used for the authentication purpose. This is the X.509 digital certificate format, where it contains the version, certificate serial number, algorithm, then the parameter. This algorithm is the signature algorithm. So, which SHA or DSS, which signature algorithm is used, that is mentioned here. The parameters are mentioned. Then the period of validity, from to date, issuer name, then the subject public key. To whom the certificate is issued. So, detail of the subject, name, algorithm, parameters and the keys. And the last part is the signature. The issuer unique identifier and subject unique identifier. Extension, algorithm, parameters and encrypted hash. So, this is available for the algorithm, parameter and encrypted hash. It is available in all versions of the X.509 digital certificates, whereas this up to this is in version 1, then this issuer unique identifier, subject unique identifier is included in version 2 and the extension is available in the further version 3. Now, if you want to install the OpenSSL in your Windows operating system, then how to install? So, you have to download the OpenSSL from the given website. Then select the suitable version as per your machine, okay, and install it on your computer. So, this is for Windows operating system. But suppose if you are working on an Ubuntu operating system, then there is no need to install the OpenSSL. It is available, okay, in your machine. So, for Windows, you have to go through the, you have to click the slide, website, and from that you have to download a suitable version. Different versions are available, okay, as per your laptop configuration. You have to install here I install Win32 OpenSSL version 1.1.1, which is a light. Okay, so it's the size is less. So I install this version on my machine. Then during this installation, it asks you certain questions. Okay, so you have to, by default it is get installed into the program files. So it asks for the location, and then it also asks for the DLL files, where to store the DLL files. So it will be preferred that you choose this OpenSSL binaries bin directory. So select the OpenSSL DLL to a bin directory. Okay, then next is, after completing the installation, it asks for the one-time $10 donation to Win32 OpenSSL. Just click on the finish, it open a page for the donation. So just close it, that window. Okay, so this OpenSSL is get installed on your machine. After this, after installation of OpenSSL, the steps are to generate the self-signed certificate. There are the two types of the certificate. One is the self-signed, means the we are giving the certificate to ourselves, whereas in the third party certificate, the CA, the authentic third party, that is called as a certification authority, they issue the certificate and their name is come under the issuer name. Okay, so here what we are doing is we are generating our own certificate, self-signed certificate. So just here in my case, I installed this OpenSSL in the program file, so it by default it get installed into this default folder, and you have to open a command prompt. So after opening a command prompt, this is a command prompt. Okay, so on the command prompt, you have to go to your specific directory, that is OpenSSL Win32 is the directory. Go to its bin and the type OpenSSL. So as soon as you type OpenSSL, it is a command. Okay, so the prompt is get changed. So the prompt is now changed. It is now OpenSSL. Initially, this is your command prompt, right? So on this command prompt, after reaching to the bin directory, you have to type this command. Otherwise, you will get the no such command error. So you have to go to the bin directory of OpenSSL and then type this command. So after typing this command, you are entering into the OpenSSL mode. Okay. So now in this OpenSSL, you have to first create the keys for certificate signing request. So the certificate is signed, right? So for signing, you have to create the keys. So GMRSA, this is the generate the RSA key, which is password protected by the DES3. So DES algorithm, that is triple DES, is used for protecting the server key. Minus hyphen out, this is the option. Okay, so the output that is generated by this command is the server.key, and this is the size of the key. 2048 is the size of the key. So here what we are doing is we are generating the RSA key, okay, which is password protected by the DES algorithm, triple DES algorithm, and the size of the key is 2048. Okay, now it asks you to enter the passphrase. So this is a you can say password for your server key. You want to protect the server key. Okay, you want to secure your server dot key, which is RSA key. Okay, so using DES or using symmetric cipher, you are protecting the server dot key. So it asks for the passphrase. Now you have to enter the minimum 4-digit passphrase. That is, password should be minimum 4-digit, and you have to remember that password. Okay, you have to remember that password. So it is minimum 4-digit, maximum 8-digit. Then after doing this, generate the key. Then RSA hyphen in server dot key hyphen out server dot key dot insecure. Its meaning is that now you have to create the insecure key, means without password protected from the server dot key, you have to create the insecure key. Okay, so again it asks you for the passphrase, because it is password protected, the server key is password protected, so it asks the passphrase. So you have to enter the same passphrase. Then it is giving you a message that it is generating the key. So now you have the two key. One is a password protector and second one is a without password protector. So this is server.key.insecure is a without password. Now the next step is you have to create the certificate signing request that we call as a CSR, certificate signing request. So for this you have to type the command request. Request means you are requesting the certificate signing. So you are giving the details of the subject. Okay, so request new, this is a new request, and the key for the signing is a server key dot insecure, and the output is a server.csr. So server.csr, this is nothing but the certificate signing request. So it shows you certain messages like this. So these messages are get displayed on your command prompt. Then it asks you for your country name. So you have to give the two letter code for your country. Okay, so they are given you the sample, that is AU is a sample. So similarly you have to give your country name as a two letter code. So I give here IN India. Then mention the state for which, from where you are belonging. So mention the state, full name, mention the locality, organization name. Okay, so here I am given the VP. Then organizational unit name, it is given as IT. And then you have to mention the server name, okay, for which you want a digital certificate. So that web server name is given. Then email address, okay, so you have to give your email address. Then there are some extra attributes that are the optional attributes, you can skip it. Okay, so challenge password and all that, these are the additional attributes, so no need to give this attributes. Just click enter, place, press enter, enter, enter. Okay, so finally you will get message that your request is generated. Then you have to create the digital certificate from the certificate signing request. So X509, this is a format, okay, and this is the command to generate the digital certificate. So X509 request, so you are requesting a digital certificate from the certificate signing request. Okay, so number of days are very important, because now this is a digital certificate, so you have to mention the validity of your certificate. So 365, that is nothing but for 1 year, you are issuing the certificate for 1 year. Okay, input is a CSR, that is the certificate signing request, and the out the signing key is a server.key.insecure. This is a signature key which we already generated in the first step. And then server.pm, so this pm is the extension which is used in a Windows. Okay, if you are doing it on Ubuntu, the same steps are there. Okay, the same steps are there, but here you have to mention server.crt. CRT, it is for the certificate. Okay, instead of PM you mention it CRT. Then it is check your signature, that is given. Okay, this is your CSR which is given. The signature is given as an input, CSR is given as an input, and then from that the certificate is created. So getting the private key. And for the Windows, your default location where this CSR file or the key file or the server certificate that are get stored into the default location, this is your default location. So in my case it is the default location. If you are not able to find your default location, just search it in a C drive. Okay, so when you search it on a C drive, you find a default location. Okay, so just search the server.pm in the C drive, so you are able to get the location. Okay, so I'll demonstrate it in the next video, that how to see the default location of your certificate. So this is my default location. It is in the users, app data, local, virtual store, program files, OpenSSL, Win32, and in the bin directory I found the server.csr, server.pm, and the key, that is server.key.insecure. So all these files are get stored in this location. Okay, now in Windows, for in Windows, you need a special software to view the your certificates. So I install the XCA. This is XCA is from Windows Store. Okay, so you can search this XCA in the Windows Store and download it on in your machine. So this Windows Store edition is you have to download to view the certificate. Then when you install that software, this and open that software, it look like this. Okay, so here you have to import the certificate from that directory. Okay, so from OpenSSL Win32 bin directory, you have to import the certificate. You have to take that certificate and you can see it here. So it looks like this. The detail of the certificate, it looks like this. The status, this is a web server. It is a self-signed. Signature is self-signed. For that, the algorithm is SHA-256 with RSA encryption. The key is a public key. This is a serial number. This is a serial number. Okay. This is a format of X509. Okay. This is the format of X509. So, fingerprints are given. Okay. Validity is mentioned. So, you are given it for 1 year. So, it is November 18, 2020 to Thursday, November 18, 2021. So, this is the validity is for 1 year. Then you can also check the other tabs like subject, issuer, comment. So, these are the different tabs you will see in the software. Okay, that software. XCA is a software which is used to visualize your certificate. So, using that software also you can create the certificate. So, this is GUI based software. Then status, subject, issuer and the comment. Okay. So, country name, which is I have already provided this information at the time of creating the CSR. So, all that information is available here as a subject. Similarly, when you click on issuer, you will get that information. Okay. This is your RSA key. So, if you want to see your key, just click on the key and you can see your server.key.insecure, which is created by the OpenSSL. Okay. And at the end, when your certificate is get ready, just mention the quit command to come out of the OpenSSL prompt. Okay. So, this is the method or for creating a self-signed certificate. And if you want the detailed information about this, you can refer this sites of OpenSSL.org and DGCert.com. So, it gives you the detailed explanation about the OpenSSL toolkit. Thank you.